First of all, Jeff and I just want to say thank you so much for the outpouring love and support. We got nothing but the best comments ever.
Don't you feel better we don't have to carry around the secret anymore?
Yes.
Always lying on Jeff and Jordan TV?
I know. For 3 months, that was so hard.
Hard. Yeah, it was, give or take.
Yes, and now I can openly just tell people, yes, I'm pregnant. And yeah, so what we were going to talk about today was the good old Mexico trip. How it
all inclusive.
Yes.
I mean, I think that's it. As everybody knows from the Dub Smash videos, we had a good time.
Oh, we did.
So we get to Mexico at the Moon Palace Resort in Cancun, and we couldn't be more excited because this is the place where we're going to have our wedding.
We went to Moon Palace a year before us
Previously.
And I absolutely fell in love with the place. Just everything's so great. The people that work there, everybody's just so nice. I love even the people vacationing there. We always end up making friends along the way. So we're having the best time in Mexico. It's all inclusive. I mean, how can you not have fun? We're meeting people. I drank too many margaritas. I know I did because...
I know I did too, apparently.
We ended up with the baby. But yeah.
You guys can fill in the blanks from there.
Yeah, we don't have to go in detail. You saw our Dub Smashes in our robes in the bathtub. That was so much fun.
Moving on. We get back from Mexico, what? The end of January?
We left for Mexico the end of January. We got back the beginning of February.
Okay, so we left for Mexico the end of January, get back the beginning of February. The date was February 22nd.
When
you woke me up crying.
Yes. So, I had a feeling that I might be pregnant. I don't know if it was just my instincts kicking in, but I was at work. It was on a Saturday. And the thought of shampooing somebody's hair or applying color was so exhausting to me. All I wanted to do was come home, get in my pajamas, and just go to sleep. And I wasn't nauseated or anything like that. It was just more so a sick feeling. So, I thought I was getting mono. And, but then I was like, no, I'm just gonna get my sleep. Maybe I'll start feeling like myself again. Then I noticed my stomach, it just constantly looked bloated and I had put on a little bit of weight, but I was eating the exact same, doing the exact same that I normally do. I was like, that's weird. So I took-
You don't show after 2 weeks of being pregnant.
No, you're bloated though. Like when you're on your period and you're bloated, that's exactly what it was. I wasn't gonna go there, but since Jeff doesn't know, I might as well just flat out say it.
So, well, I feel pregnant then every Sunday because the weekend gets after me.
So all you women know what I'm talking about. When you're on your period and you're bloated, that's what my stomach looked like constantly. So that's another clue that I thought.
It's gonna be a fun 9 months.
So then, and I'm very moody lately. So then I took a pregnancy test and it was the one with the lines. And so I was just like, oh my gosh, I'm pregnant.
No, you were, how were you really?
No, I wasn't done.
Oh, okay.
And then I just started crying. Cause my mind was so set on the wedding. I was so excited about Mexico. We had the best time and I was like, I'm not ready to be a mom yet. Like, we're not ready at all. We're just doing things on the weekends, doing little getaways. We're always like having fun. Like, I'm not prepared for motherhood. I don't want a crying baby. That's how I felt. So I wake him up at 7 a.m, bawling crying. He thought somebody had died because that's how hard I was crying.
Yeah, it didn't seem like good news when she woke me up.
Then he was actually a champ about it. He took it, I feel like, how a woman would, and I took it like a man. And he was just like hugging me. He was like, it's okay. Like, it's fine. Don't worry about it.
It's okay.
And I was like, the wedding. And I don't even know
what I channeled my father. My father my whole life was always so calm about every situation. And I don't know, maybe it was like my father, like, I looked at the lines or whatever that's on there, and they were exactly the same as the box. And I was like, listen, just don't worry. These things are off a lot of the times. So in my head, I was like, oh my God, Am I still asleep? Is this a dream? And I was like, wake up. Come on, wake up, wake up. And I was like, let's go to CVS, see if we could get another one. Let's do it a couple times. These things aren't 100% accurate.
So I go to CVS, well, we both go to CVS and we buy a 2-pack. And I was like, nope, we have to get a digital one that says yes or no, because I didn't believe the lines.
Yeah.
So, and then I tell Jeff, I'm like, I'm peeing in a cup this time and I'm putting it in the cup. And because I thought maybe.
And we went to the bank, right? And I stole a cup from the bank.
Because I wasn't going to use one of our cups to pee in. We stole a cup, a plastic cup.
I'm like, here, pee this at the bank. And then we stole the cup. I think
I put the cup in my purse. It was a plastic cup. And anyways, so I pee on the cup, and he's cooking. And
in the cup.
I pee in the cup. And then Jeff's
cooking. Peed all over the cup, and then we tested it.
You wait 3 minutes, and I told Jeff, I said, do you want to look at this? Do you want to look first? And Jeff was like, no, you
don't. We were standing right there. I remember it. I was like, we're having a baby. In my head, I'm already preparing myself. Like, we're having a baby. And sure enough, we went in there with the pee on the counter in the cup.
And it said yes.
Yeah.
I call my mom, because I call my mom about everything. And I'm like, Mom, I got to tell you something. She goes, you're pregnant. And I go, how did you know? And she said, when we talked a couple days ago, I had a feeling, an overwhelming feeling that you were. And I go, what?
Yeah.
And she goes, I knew you were pregnant when we talked the other day. And she told me too, I said, well, how accurate were the pregnancy tests when you took them for me, Jana, and Peyton? She said, I had all three of you when I took them. And I was like, ah! Crying.
The whole day, I just remember feeling like, I'm dreaming. I'm going to wake up soon. You know, like, I don't know if you guys ever had that. You ever had that feeling where you walk around like, I know I'm in a dream, but I'm right. going to wake up. So that's kind of how I felt. Not that it was bad or I was free. It was just, it's a lot to be like, I'm going to be somebody's father. Like, you know, so that's, you're trying to wrap your head around that. The very next morning, Jordan wakes me up. She's going to work.
I'm crying.
It's 7:00. She wakes me up hysterical again. Now for sure, this is going to be bad news. What's wrong? Somebody stole our car. I'm like, what do you mean someone stole our car? I'm like, what is going on in my life? I'm having a baby. Now I'm running around at 7 a.m. looking to see where this car is at. Sure enough, it got towed because we have 2 cars and the plates were out of date. You know, I don't want to get into all this story, but
it's another way for California to make more money.
I tracked down the car. Sure enough, it's towed. I mean, I'm like, these are not the best 2 days I've had, you know, in a while. But all that aside, wrapping our heads around all that.
I was so hard. I was like, what is going on in my life? And he was like, if you wake me up one more time,
I'm like,
and something else.
Yeah, the third day, I'm like, you better let me sleep today. Like, it's over.
And like a week before that, I think my car was parked at work and somebody hit the door and it like dented the door. And he was mad because I forgot to tell him because it's his car. And
she pulls up. She's like, run something outside. I run outside and there's a huge dent in the door. I'm like, what happened to the door? And she's like, oh, I forgot to tell you, somebody hit it. I'm like,
but they didn't leave a note or anything, and there was no way.
But it was in a parking garage. You tell the attendant, hey, somebody smashed my car. Do you have cameras in there? Is there something I can do? Jordan's like, oh, well.
Well, I mean, there's nothing you can do about it. Somebody hit it, and I don't know. I told him, I was like, maybe we could get, you know, it's the infomercials of Papa Dent or something.
The Dent King.
Actually,
my mom had that back home, and it works a little bit.
Yeah.
But we're getting sidetracked.
But then all those things were happening all at one time. You know, when it rains, it pours. Well, it was pouring on my life at that time. And
I don't think the news we got was bad news, us having a baby by any means. The towing of the car was bad news. But it's just a lot to wrap your head around. You know, like everyone says, you know, people take it differently, you know, when you find out you're going to be a parent.
Well, when your mind is set on, we had all the addresses for everybody for the wedding, and our mind was completely on wedding. And then me, a couple days after that, I was supposed to try on dresses with this lady. She was coming into town, and I was so excited about that and I had so much fun in Mexico that I just wasn't thinking about a kid at that time. But now, fast forwarding through all
looking back in retrospect,
now I'm happy.
Our future looks brighter, but definitely we're having a baby. I bet he's gonna look just like you.
Oh, I hope not.
We're having a baby.
I'll bet she'll speak with an accent like you.
She?
Yeah.
We're having a baby. My baby.
Now that we have you guys all up to pace about what happened in Mexico, about the baby, you know.
Basically. Use your imagination a little bit.
Exactly. And how our first reactions were, we are so excited now. We went to the doctor, the baby's healthy. That's a blessing.
Right, and we're, like I said, we were just in shock when it first happened. That's why we were nervous and crying and, you know, your life changes like that, but now we're so happy about, you know, the future and everything, and we're excited and still naive about certain things.
Well, I find out in a couple weeks what I'm having, and I can't wait to find that out, because then you can start buying things for the baby, and I'll be very good at that.
Me too. Again, guys, we just want to say thank you so much, honestly, from the bottom of our hearts. The love that you guys showed us on social media and all the messages we got was overwhelming. I mean, we were on Big Brother 7 years ago, and, you know, you guys still show us this awesome support. And thanks, Entertainment Tonight, for supporting us weekly, for getting the story out there and helping us share this wonderful moment. So, honestly, guys, thank you so much.
Yes, thank you. And next week, tune in, because we're going to get you guys up to speed on the wedding ceremony and how it went down at the courthouse. So don't forget to tune in, because we have a whole lot of stuff.
Thanks, guys. We'll see you then.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
All right.
But.
I don't even know what I'm saying. Exciting.
I know.
And classy.
I didn't know it at first, but she told me, and now I know.
Okay, not Judge Jordan. A new TV show coming out, by the way.
So, anyways.